Good evening, Shadow Hills High School families. This is Mr. Fajardo, your school principal, welcoming you to the virtual back to school night today, Wednesday, September 16th, 2020. I have some information to cover with you this evening, and we will get you well on your way to visit your Google Classrooms with your students this evening to ensure that you get all the information regarding our syllabus for the first and second semester for this school year, as well as important information that your teachers have to share with you as parents and guardians and all of our families here with Shadow Hills High School. All right, so let me walk you through a few things here. So our teachers will be providing you with some information in terms of how to best contact them. So you'll see probably a lot of our teachers providing a business card sort of feel to the presentation that they'll be sharing with you via the Google Classrooms or by sending you a link to their actual YouTube videos. So what you'll see on here is contact information for their email, in addition to whether or not if a teacher does have their teacher Twitter handle. Here's mine, for example. It's at @SHHS_principal, as well as a Facebook page they may have, as well as the website for the teacher. All right. So moving on to the next part, you'll hear a lot of our teachers provide you some information about who they are. So in this case, this is my about me message for your quick reference. And so I just wanted to point out that if you do have any questions, parents or guardians or any family members that have any questions related to Shadow Hills High School, please do send me an email. You can always email me, as I mentioned earlier, at gabriel.fajardo@desertsands.us. Okay. So our next slide here has a lot to do with our school vision. I'm huge when it comes to having a vision. You know, coming from the business world, it's important to always have vision statement that does suggest where we see our students a few years down the road post-graduation, right? So our vision here, and I've bold typeface fonted a few words here for your quick reference, and they will make a bit of a difference later on through my presentation. But I really wanted to highlight the opportunity for me to say this, and I'll read the last sentences. We do strive to develop critical thinkers who can analyze the questions of today to create the solutions for tomorrow. So I wanted to provide you that vision in the context of my following slides when I get into our academic focus for this year, as well as what we're focusing on in terms of essential standards, in terms of the learning your students will be conducting this school year. So having said what I just shared with you, our collective why is a very important thing for all of our families and our students to understand. Our teachers have worked very hard at providing us their why in terms of what we do, what we do. And our why statement is simply this, and it is to prepare all of our students to be college, career, and community ready. How we do that is on the left side of this particular slide. And you can see MTSS is an acronym that stands for our multi-tiered system of supports. And our system of supports starts with our vision, our mission, our school goals. It has a lot to do with our professional learning communities, how we've adopted WICR strategies by way of AVID school-wide, and how we work with our teachers in terms of the rigor and relevance frameworks, our math teachers with their standards for mathematical practice, the science engineering practices for our science teachers, and so on. On the right side, you see what the results are. So we have our why, you have our how, and what is the what? Right? Well, the what is we want to prepare every single student to be a 21st century prepared student. And we do that by providing the very best that we have to offer. Our A through G courses, obviously preparing our students to take the SBAC exam and meeting that with the standards met or better, providing opportunities for our students to take AP exams, dual enrollment opportunities, how we leverage our California State Seal of Biliteracy for graduates, in addition to those graduates that do have the Golden State Seal of Merit on their diploma as well. And what we do with all this is we take our why, we know the how, and we add it to our what, right? And we prepare our student to be that 21st century prepared student. So that's just a little context for you to have as a quick reference as we go through the presentation today. In addition to our why statement, we also have our student learning outcomes. Our student learning outcomes are simply statements that specify what we want our students to know and what we want them to be able to do or to demonstrate when they've completed their program here with us at Shadow Hills High School. And so while our SLOWs are really measurable and observable outcomes, we also focus a lot on skill sets. So we want our Knights to be knowledgeable. We want them to be noble in their ability to analyze, evaluate, and synthesize literacy and numeracy learning targets. We want them to be innovative by being problem solvers, goal-oriented to be those ethical decision makers that always show respect for themselves and for others, to be healthy students that maintain those positive relationships with one another, having a growth mindset on learning. We want them to be technology natives that demonstrate digital literacy and citizenship to redefine their learning experiences while they're here at Shadow Hills High School. And finally, to be socially responsible Knights. Because after all, our goal is to ensure that they are college, community, and obviously life ready. So we want them to be socially responsible Knights as well. So moving right along to our next slide, when we talk about being socially responsible, this is where our mantra comes into play, what we call our motto, or in some cases we call this our posture. When we say a Knight does it right, it does have meaning. It means something. And so this next slide actually outlines what right, that term acronym, really means to us. So when we say respect, when we say to have integrity, when we say what it means to have greatness, what it means to demonstrate honor, right? Having the highest character and integrity that is both evident in the classroom and our hallways and activities, right? And what it means to be part of a team, this teamwork concept, which is very important to us. So when we say Knights do it right, this is exactly what we mean by that. They're not just words that are simply typed up on a Google slide, but more importantly, it's the values by which we make our decisions It's the values that which guide our behavior. And more importantly, it's an opportunity for us to consistently recast our posture to all of our stakeholders on campus. And what does that mean for us in distance learning? Well, our Knight Stewart Wright Committee has put together this draft of what it means not only to be right, but also to have pride, particularly during distance learning. And the acronym for pride is simply this. It's to be present every day. Are you present? Are you engaged? Do you prepare yourself to be engaged during distance learning? Do you have respect for one another while you're conducting your distance learning Zoom lessons? Do you operate with a sense of integrity, right? So turning in your work on time, using Zoom for school purposes only, being supportive of your classmates, right? It's important to have that integrity and establish that in a variety of ways. Obviously, discipline, are you doing what is right, right? Attending all your classes every day, following those class procedures. Despite the fact that we're still in distance learning, we want every single one of our Knights to engage on a daily basis with our teachers. And then finally, the E, standing for effort. Are you providing the very best effort? Are you providing and actually conducting yourself and providing the very best version of who you really are by participating and being very thoughtful and neat with your work and helping others who might need it as well? And so we just wanted to take the time to share this from our Knight Stewart Wright Committee, particularly during this distance learning that we find ourselves in. So again, just an opportunity for us to share with you that being right is one acronym, but also having that Knight pride is just as important, particularly during distance learning. So moving right along. So I'm going to set up now what your teachers will be discussing with you, families and students, about what our focus is during distance learning and the rest of the school year. You'll hear our teachers talk about essential standards, right? And essential standards are selected by our collaborative teams that are set up by grade level teams in English and in math and in science, as well as the other core content areas. So what they do is they actually guarantee that all of our students will know and be able to master those essential standards by the end of the school year. So our teachers have been tasked to provide the time and the support necessary for students who haven't mastered those standards to provide them with those extended learning opportunities, whether it's through intervention, enrichment, and or remediation. So this way we can ensure that those students do get those standards and do have those mastered, right? And so our essential standards, while they don't necessarily represent all that the students will learn this school year, they represent at the very minimum what a student must be able to learn to reach the higher levels of learning. So when you hear about our focus on learning, this is what we're going to be discussing with you during our back to school night with all the teachers' videos and the presentations that we'll be providing for you this evening. So remember what I talked about earlier with our vision statement. Critical thinking for us is embedded in our vision statement. And that is simply something that we all agreed upon as a faculty and staff to hone in on. Because we realize one thing, and that one thing is this, that 21st century skills are a necessity. We've worked through the American Business Association and really sought out from them what are the skill sets that high school students need to really hone in on. And one of those skill sets is critical thinking. We really want to engage our students in levels of critical thinking that they haven't experienced before. And we are of great benefit because we do have Avid school-wide where we can utilize our Wicker strategies to be able to really hone in on those critical thinking skills that will allow our students to have this self-direction, to have the self-discipline, to self-monitor, and to self-correct their levels of thinking, regardless of whatever class they're in, how deep we're able to get our students to think through those situations, will provide them the opportunity and really unleash their sophistication to be able to have and foster a deeper love of learning. Because after all, we are a school and our focus is on learning, and that to us is the Knight's way. So you hear a lot of our teachers in terms of how they apply rigor into their classroom and how that's associated with the levels of thinking that we're really gonna challenge our students to have that productive struggle to be able to critically think and apply those skill sets in every single one of their classes. Now, in addition to that, we also want to celebrate the opportunity for our students to demonstrate growth. So a lot of the parents here, as well as your students, have already been very familiarized with how we are using our iReady diagnostic to really allow for our teachers to garner the data that's necessary to drive their instruction. So when we say and ask you, do you want your night to be celebrated? Parents, we really need your help. We need your help for students to complete the iReady diagnostic. And a diagnostic is simply this. It's really to try to take a snapshot of what skill sets your students currently have and possess in both reading and mathematics. And from this benchmark diagnostic, we will then take the time to have our teachers really kind of look at that and inspect the data to be able to use that to drive their instruction. And more importantly, we want to demonstrate growth. We want to see if whether or not our students by January, the next time we give this diagnostic, will have been an opportunity to have demonstrated academic achievement, right? So please do encourage your student to complete those assessments. We need to complete it before the end of the month. And if you have questions about those, please do reach out to your student's English teacher or their math teacher via email. So thank you for helping us out to finalize those iReady assessments and really get us to a position to recognize our students accordingly. The next slide talks about our social emotional learning target for this year. So in addition to the academic learning target that we have for building critical thinking skills across the disciplines, we also looked at an opportunity for us to embed our SEL learning for this school year. So during distance learning, your students are exposed during six period twice a week to lessons that center around social emotional learning. And this school year, our focus is in developing the self-efficacy of every single one of our nights. We want every single one of our students to respond to those questions there, those four statements, that they are completely confident in their ability to do those four things. And I think together with your help, parents at home, to support our teachers to do that, we can certainly help our nights develop the self-efficacy by reinforcing their strengths and helping them to identify the steps necessary to achieve their goals. And it really starts with the mindset of, I think I can. That's why in one of my dispatches, I shared with you the story about the train and how Casey took the time to kid up that mountain, that railroad mountain, and knowing how important it is to just simply think that you can do something. That's what we mean by developing the self-efficacy of our students. So parents, I know we got this, and I'm going to rely on your help to make that happen. All right. So now let's move on and transition over to what the Google Classroom visits will look like. So as I mentioned earlier, our teachers will be reviewing their course syllabus with you. They'll hone in on the essential standards that we'll be focusing on for each of those core disciplines, right? They'll also review with you what their grading practices are for each of the particular courses that your child is enrolled in with here us at Shadow Hills High School. They'll also review the makeup work policy with you, in addition to reviewing any important dates that they may want to highlight, and more importantly, also providing you with an opportunity to how to best contact our teachers. So having said that, what are you going to do next, right, parents and students? I'm going to rely on you to help your parents to do this. So visiting virtual classrooms this evening will be fairly simple. Your student will guide you through how to access the Google Classroom for each of their periods. In addition, they'll walk you through and you'll find a welcome message from our teachers that will be posting something in our learning management system. In this case, it's Google Classroom. And you'll find information about that from your teachers. And I encourage you to please leave a message. So work with your student to leave a message in the stream with the discussion board by simply stating, hey, Mr. Fajardo was here. Thank you for the information. We look forward to a great school year, right? We want to make sure that our teachers know that you had an opportunity to visit them during our virtual back to school night. So thank you for that in advance. And once again, if you ever have questions for myself or any of the other administrators, again, there is my email for your quick reference. Make sure you do jot that down, por favor. And then finally, just wanted to give another shout out to our business card here, our virtual business card. Again, do follow me on Twitter or Facebook if you haven't already. And please do also visit our website. I'm always constantly having it updated on a daily basis at www.shadowhillshs.com. And once again, families, I do thank you for joining us this evening. at our virtual back to school night. Thank you so much for your time and energies this school year. And always remember that nights do it right. Have a great evening.